sure all of you will agree with me that in a matter of 2 years, we've changed the fortunes of agriculture in this country. And you are yet, you haven't seen anything yet, because there's a lot coming. So we've done this year, in April, the president launched Planting for Export and Rural Development. It may not occur to you the link with the subject, the theme of what we are doing today. It is a selection of 6 crops, 3 crops. We are talking about oil palm, rubber, coffee, cashew, mango, and which is the 6th one? These, and coconut. We are taking these 6 crops in collaboration with the local government ministry. All the district chief executives and municipal and metropolitan chief executives have been given an assignment to raise seedlings of a certain target every year and give them free of charge to farmers to plant. The pilot was started in 2017, a very quiet way. I was experimenting. And we stepped it up last year. And you know, it's one of the most popular programs that we've introduced. And you see that occasionally you look out for it. And the papers, oh, this district chief executive is distributing 32,000 seedlings of this or that and that and that and that. And the idea is that we want to grow each of these 6 crops to earn this country the 2 billion that cocoa is earning. Each of them should be earning the 2 billion. So in the next 5-7 years, we have installed the capacity for cashew to export 2 billion worth of just the raw cashew. Forget about the addition. The same thing for coconut, for coffee, and the others. And you know, it's very simple arithmetic. If you have 6 crops, each giving you $2 billion, that's what? $12 billion. In addition to the raw cocoa, it's what? $14 billion. Can you imagine what it would do to the economy of this country? Honestly, we don't need oil. We don't need the gold and everything, diamonds, and we don't need it. Because suddenly, your capacity to earn foreign exchange would have expanded through the roof. And then you can afford to be able to invest in your social amenities, like your schools, your hospitals, your infrastructure, without having to go to the euro market to borrow euro bonds. We don't need it. God has given this country the potential for all these crops. And we've sat by them, and we've been claiming poverty all our generations. And this government, Akufo-Addo, recognizes that it has to stop. We just have to take the right measures to install the capacity, and we are done. And we are talking about if cocoa were to convert everything into chocolate and other cocoa products, how much we would earn from the 2 billion to maybe 8 billion. So each one of these 6 crops, in addition to producing the raw material, if you were to process them here and export, we're talking about $30-40 billion. And I'm not dreaming, because I'm in charge and I know exactly what we are doing on the ground to make it happen. And it's going to happen. It's going to happen. We are very determined to make it happen because we know the way to make it happen. Some of us have helped other countries in our careers to set up similar things. So we are here and we want Ghana to also benefit from these things. And when we're talking about Ghana, we're talking about our farmers. At the moment, I'm sure you and I know, the poorest group of workers in Ghana are farmers. Nobody can convince me about it. But don't you ever think that has always been the case? I'm the son of a cocoa farmer. That's how I got into agriculture. My father used to take me to his cocoa farm, many, many miles away from Kumasi. But he used to take us on holiday. And in those days, the richest group of of workers in Ghana were cocoa farmers. Ashanti Newtown, Kumasi, was built on cocoa farming. People would go out there those days, the old Amazonia varieties. It takes 7-8 years to yield. They'll go into the bush for 7-8 years. And they come back and build these big 10-bedroom Spanish houses. You come to Ashanti Utah, you have never seen any architecture like that. And I'll invite you to come. And that's purely on cocoa and on the beans. Can you imagine in the 50s, if they had the capacity to process the chocolate, there would be a lot of billionaires in Ghana today. But where are we now? They have been turned into the poorest group of farmers. So the potential is there, and we are determined to milk that potential. So the Planting for Export and Rural Development is exactly what it's saying. To the extent that I didn't even know that you could grow cashew in Wa, in Sisala, and all those northern areas. Thousands and hundreds of thousands of seedlings are now being distributed in these areas for them to plant. And I go there and I tell them, Akufo-Addo is bringing your cocoa. This is your equivalent of cocoa in the south. So take it. And they are taking it. They are queuing in front of DCE bungalows and offices looking for the seedlings to plant. And we are encouraging them. Not only that, we are instituting an authority equivalent to Ghana Cocoa Board to take charge, to promote, to develop, and control this as under one umbrella. So I have gotten through, piloted through cabinet, is now in parliament, a bill which the Select Committee on Food, Agriculture, and Cocoa Affairs is going to meet on it before the end of this month in Koforidua to consider it, to bring back to. And we have an authority, Tree Development Authority, which is going to oversee this massive diversification of our agricultural economy and find the money, and it will be hands-off government. It will be controlled and managed by the participants themselves, from the farmers to the traders to the processors to the exporters. We will be levying at each stage. So to be self-financing has nothing to do with the Minister of Finance. To be a self-financing, self-regulating authority, and it's not a new idea. I mean, I stole it from Cote d'Ivoire. You go there, you see it. That's where I found it, and I brought it here. So there's a lot happening in the commodity trade. And I'm saying all this to you because you form the core of the commodity industry in Ghana. So you ought to know what we are doing as a government. And I'm saying that on all policy fronts, there has never been such a massive initiative to develop our commodity trade. I think I will stop here and be interactive. I want you to tell me something and I'll tell you something. Thank you.